I'm Andrea Wu, a developer relations engineer on Firebase, which is Google's app development platform.
Hello, I'm Rekha Kumar, a software engineer from the Firebase personalization team at Google.
A lot of developers use Firebase in the app development process, and many use AdMob to show ads for driving app revenue. A common issue is perhaps not making as much revenue as expected. And we're here today to walk through how AdMob with Firebase can help optimize and increase app revenue using Firebase Remote Config, specifically personalization. A developer hearing about that for the first time might look something like this. I've worked so hard and for so long on this app, but I don't know how to make more money from it. I'm going to take a break and eat some chocolate and ice cream.
Oh, hey, Andrea. Having a rough day?
Yeah, I just looked at my revenue over the last year for this app that I made, and the data is really depressing. I basically haven't really made a lot from it, and I've tried different strategies already, but whatever I'm trying just doesn't seem to be working.
What does your app do? What have you tried?
I really like the outdoors, so I made this app with Firebase to help people track their outdoor activities and share it with their friends. I use ads to generate revenue, but I'm having a hard time knowing where to put these ads in my app and how often to show them so users don't just leave the app out of annoyance.
Have you tried different ad positioning or different ad frequencies?
I have. I've tried different ad positions using A/B testing, but I haven't invested too much time into it.
Can you tell me more about how you're using ads?
Sure. I'm using AdMob for displaying ads, and I thought it would be a good way to show ads on banners, interstitials, and videos, as well as native ads. It's connected to networks all around the world and helps me optimize for ads that pay me the most.
So what I'm hearing is you're using Firebase and you're using AdMob. Did you know you could use them together?
What do you mean by that?
Well, AdMob can collect some basic metrics that you can also view in the Firebase console as a start. This requires linking your Firebase project and the app that you configured in the AdMob console. Where the integration gets even better is if you use the Firebase SDK for Google Analytics. You can then use some more Firebase products to drive app revenue.
What Firebase products would you recommend?
You can use Firebase Remote Config. It works really well with AdMob and Google Analytics.
Oh, cool. I actually already use Remote Config to control and change the behavior and appearance of my app without needing to release a new version every time I change my code. I really like that I don't have to set up any complicated and time-consuming infrastructure to do any of that.
Nice. What have you used it for so far?
Well, I've used it to implement feature flags for when I'm developing new features, and I used it to A/B test where to put these ads in my app. It has also been really helpful for when I want to give custom experiences for different user segments.
These are some great ways to use Remote Config. Have you heard of personalization?
Yeah, I heard about it last year, and I've seen it somewhere in Remote Config on Firebase console, but I don't really know much more beyond that. Can you tell me more?
Sure. Personalization can help select the optimal user experience and maximize the metric that you're interested in.
That sounds really awesome. How does it know which alternative to provide?
Magic. Just kidding. Sort of. It uses machine learning to suggest the optimal choice at that time to each user based on their past app behavior.
It does really sound like magic, but it also sounds like A/B testing. Are they different?
I'm glad you asked. There are a lot of similarities between personalization and A/B testing, but they are definitely different. In A-B testing, you would run an A-B test to figure out the optimal option for the entire target audience. Whereas in personalization, each user may get a different experience based on their past app behavior. There's a video with more details if you'd like to check that out.
Amazing. Thanks. So going back to my ad revenue problem, how would I use personalization?
One way to increase ad revenue is to have more ad clicks. For example, you could use personalization to serve ads at different frequencies. Personalization in the background will try to figure out which ad frequency will result in the most ad clicks for each of your users.
Sounds interesting. I'd love to try it out. Do you mind helping me set up personalization?
Sure. Let's open the Firebase console and pick your project.
Will do. What should I do from here?
Go to remote config. And there's that add parameter button over there on the right. Let's click on that.
Ah, so this is actually the same as adding any other parameter. So I already know how to do that. I'm going to name my parameter add frequency and maybe add a description of optimizing ad revenue based on ad frequency.
Looks good. Next, we'll want to click on that add new button near the bottom and click on personalization.
Oh, neat. It opens up another panel for me to fill out some fields.
First, let's figure out what different ad frequencies you would like. You can have up to 5 of those.
Okay, so I guess I'll try 4 frequencies for now. 5 minutes, 10 minutes, 15, and 20.
Great. Next, we'll have to select the objective. This is the metric that personalization is going to try to maximize.
I say ad clicks here, which is what I want to maximize in my case. What if I want to optimize a metric that isn't one of these 2 predefined ones?
Great question. You can add custom events as an objective. Just type the event name that you want to use. Remember, you need to trigger these events later from your app.
Okay, what about these additional metrics over here? What's that?
These are metrics that don't affect values served by personalization. It is just for helping you track additional metrics.
Ah, so as mentioned earlier, I'm always worried about whether users will stop using my app if I show more ads. Could I use these additional metrics to gain some insight into this?
Absolutely. In your case, user engagement time would be a good one to track.
I'll go ahead and select user engagement time then. Next, it seems like I need to choose the group of users who will get these personalized values.
That's right. It's important to note that a portion of the chosen user group will be reserved for baseline, or what we think of as control group of users. These users will get random values and not personalized values. This will enable us to measure how personalization performed compared to the baseline.
Alrighty. I'll try this out on all of my Android users first. And if that works, I'll try it on my other users later. I'll create a new condition as usual in remote config, and I'll give it a name. I'll pick platform and Android to choose my user segment. So now it looks like I'm done creating the condition. And after I save it, I see it in this personalization panel.
Yep, we've filled out all the steps for personalization. So you can go ahead and save it.
Looks like the personalized parameter I just created is showing up here. Do I need to give it a default value?
Yes. I suggest you give the default value that you're most comfortable with for your non-Android users.
I'll give it a default value of, let's say, 15 minutes then. So now I'll save the parameter and publish the template. Like other remote config parameters, these values can be used right away in my app, right?
Yes, you can start serving these personalized values right away, but the algorithm does take some time to learn the optimal option for each user. Now that we've completed the setup, do you want to update your app code to use these values?
I was just about to say that. So let's take a look at my Android app. Since I've been using other Firebase products, I already have the Firebase SDK installed. How should I get the personalized values for my ad frequency parameter?
It's actually the same as getting the parameter values that you've already been using so far in remote config.
Makes sense. So normally, I create the singleton remote config object, which is used to store parameter values. And in this case, I'll get the value of the add frequency parameter.
Yes, that'll give you the personalized value for each user. So every user is going to see ads with a different frequency.
I remember we also set up an additional metric to see how often users' engagement time changes as a result of this ad frequency. Do I need to do anything with that?
In this case, user engagement is already tracked with Google Analytics, so you don't really need to do anything.
Sounds good. Is that it? Is there anything else I need to do?
That's it in this case. But if you had picked a custom event for your objective metric or additional metric, you would need to fire those events in your code.
I see. So it seems like the code setup is done.
Yes. Personalization will start serving values immediately, but it'll take some time to figure out the optimal ad frequency for each user. Let's check the results in a couple of weeks.
Alrighty, so by now, personalization should have some results.
Hopefully. We can go back into the remote config console and check out how personalization is performing. Look for the ad frequency parameter and click on it. It'll show the results page with the metrics.
Wow, this graph is really cool. It compares my baseline users who I remember you saying get a random value versus those who experience the app using personalization. Seems like personalization here is working pretty well then, as the line for personalization is above the baseline, and there's a positive number here for the lift.
Right on. Note that the baseline group is much smaller than the personalization group, so the results in the baseline group are scaled up, making the numbers comparable to calculate the total lift. There's also that user engagement button over there, and if you want to click on that, we can see how user engagement time is impacted.
Looks like good news here too. User engagement time doesn't seem to be impacted when I'm optimizing for ad clicks. Phew.
Yay.
Thanks so much for your help. Personalization does seem really helpful for increasing my app revenue, and I'm excited to use it more to see how else it can help in my app.
Personalization can be used for much more than just driving app revenue. It can be used for personalizing any other app experience, like game difficulty, the right time to remind the user to rate your app, or to update color schemes.
To get started with personalization and remote config, check out links in the description. Happy personalizing!
Happy personalizing!